Today let's make this quick snappy camera animation inside of Blender. This camera movement can even make a default cube look awesome. Maybe not a default cube, but you get the point. I'm also going to explain the whole concept visually as well, so that you become an expert in it. Kind of. Let the tutorial begin. This is our initial animation. Let's figure out how to make that quick camera movements now. The first thing we should do is figure out which camera angle should we be using. So for that, let's go to the first frame and look for an interesting camera angle. I think this looks good. Let's select our camera, hit I for the keyframe menu to pop up, and select location and rotation. Okay, that's good. Now let's go to frame number 50. Let's take another frame. Okay, I want this frame. Again, I'm going to select the camera, I, location, rotation. Let's go to the last frame and select another camera angle. Select our camera, I, location, rotation. And now these are the three camera angles we have. Okay, that is looking good. Now what happens if I play it? Well, something really crazy is happening, right? The reason why that is happening is because the camera doesn't know where to point. The camera knows where to move, but the camera doesn't know where to point. So to fix that, let me show you how that works visually.
This is our object. And this is our camera. If I keyframe it over here and over here, it looks good. But if I play it back, the camera will not point to our object, even though it is following our final keyframe positions. That is because the camera right now knows where to move, but it doesn't know where to point. So what should we do? We need to point the camera somehow. For that, I'm going to use another small object and going to tell the camera point to this object. And now the camera knows where to point and where to move, giving us the exact behavior we need from the camera. The camera movement will not break even if the object keeps on changing, because our movement only depends on the keyframes and the point to object. Now let's jump back into the tutorial.
Now to do that inside of Blender, we are going to use an empty. So right now we can move our 3D cursor by using the shortcut shift and right mouse button, and we can move our 3D cursor. I'm going to put an empty in the middle of our frame, kind of middle of our frame. Shift A, empty, plane axis. Okay, now we have added the empty, but the camera doesn't know that the camera should be pointing to the empty. And for that, I'm going to select my camera, object constraint properties, add object constraint, track 2. I'm going to select the eyedropper and select this empty. Okay, now the camera just snapped to it. So let's move forward and see what happens. Yeah, now you can see the camera is always pointing to that empty. Okay, that is good. But I only want the camera to point it when it's in this frame, right? It shouldn't be pointing at that empty when it's at this frame. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to keyframe the influence to 0 at that frame. And in the first frame, I'm going to keyframe the influence to 1. And now you can see only at the first frame it is pointing to it. After that, empty has 0 influence. Okay, that is good. So let's go to our second frame. And let's add another empty over here. Empty plane axis. Let's go to our camera. Let's create a new track 2. I drop it to this empty. Yeah, somewhere over here. And you can like change the framing with the empty right here. I want something like this. Okay, that looks good. I'm going to go to my camera and tell here it should be 1 influence. But in the first frame, it should be 0 influence. Let's play that. Okay, that is looking good. The first and second frame transition is looking on point right now. Now the last frame, we have to do the same thing again. I'm going to add the 3D cursor over here, add an empty plane axis. Select my camera, track 2, eyedropper, select our empty. Let me just reposition my empty to get the frame I wanted. Yeah, that looks good. I don't want any influence from our second empty. keyframe that. Let's keyframe this. And in the first two camera frames, I don't want it to have any influence over the LMT. Go back, let's set it to 0 as well. Okay, now you can see. For our first camera keyframe area, it is 100. That's good. For the next one, it's 010. That's also correct. For the last one, it's 001. That's also correct. So now, if we play it, you can see the camera movement is being kept. Okay, that is looking good. Now what I want to do is, I want the camera movements to snap. It shouldn't be like a super smooth transition between them. So for that, what we are going to do is, we have to go into our graph editor. I'm going to select all objects, and now we are getting our keyframes over here. I'm not going to play with the influence of this. The only thing I want is XYZ location and XYZ rotation. I'm going to hide this for now so that I don't mistakenly edit that. I'm going to go into individual origins and scale it on the x-axis. Let's see what happens. You can see right now it is snapping. When it gets to a point, it becomes super snappy. Yeah, that is the look I wanted. Whenever if I feel like the frame can be better, I can like easily move my empty and like nothing breaks. So for the last one as well, I want to place the empty a bit further down. Yeah, somewhere over there. And that is how you can make a super snappy camera movement inside of Blender. I hope you found this video helpful. Subscribe for more Blender stuff. Thanks for watching.